Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. This video is the continuation of the previous video on WordPress multi-site setup. In previous video, we have seen how to set up EC2 instance with Bitnami WordPress multi-site image, then how to configure DNS domains, and finally we have seen how to enable the multi-sites in WordPress and link those sites to the corresponding domains. And we followed the subdomain multi-site approach. In this video, we are going to see how to enable the e-commerce functionality to the websites, then how we can configure the website for enabling the end-to-end product checkout, and we are going to see how to add a custom product to the store. Then finally, we are going to see how to enable the multi-sites through subfolders instead of subdomains. As I said earlier, in previous video, we have seen how to enable the multi-sites through subdomain, but here we are going to, in this video, we are going to see how to enable the multi-sites through subfolders. Let us start with enabling the e-commerce functionalities to the websites. For that, let us log in to the WP admin of the base store, mycitystore.albinsblog.com. I'm logging through the super user. After login, click on plugins, add new on the top, then search for WooCommerce, yeah, you can see the WooCommerce plugin, then install. Okay, you can do a network activate. It means like this is a networked setup, a multi-site setup. The plugin will be enabled for all the website, our case two websites, store.albinsblog.com and store1.store.albinsblog.com. Okay, now let us access the website and see, is there any change? Yeah, no change. The little theme is different, but the e-commerce functionality is not enabled because the plugin is enabled. But somehow we are not configured. Now we need to configure it. So let me log out and log in again to reflect the plugin changes. So yeah, log out, then again log in again. Now click on dashboard and come little down and you will see there is a button called run the setup wizard. Then just click on that. Yeah, yes please. Yeah, enter the address, some test address you can enter. Yeah, click. Continue. Okay, select whatever the store type. I'm selecting food and drink, then click continue. Then I'm going to select physical products. Click continue. Yeah, here like select some values. I'm creating, yeah, 1000, then no. Yeah, currently I'm not selling anywhere. I'm unselecting all the social say. Okay, continue. And now you need to select a theme. Now I am going with the free themes. Select on the free themes. You can select any of the themes you want. Okay, I'm selecting this theme for now. Yeah, the theme is installed and activated. Now click on yes please here. Click continue. Yeah, here you can see now we need to set up our store. Add your first product. Click on that. Add manually for now, so we are not going to import anything right now. Now, yeah, if you do that, you can see a section called design your site. Click on let's go. This will like install the sample product. The sample products are going to be same across all the store, only the theme is going to be different. But I will show you how to, you can add a new product, you can delete all the sample product and you can add your own product, site specific product. So, but initially these products are going to be same all the across all the sites. Yeah, now this configuration is done. Click on publish. Okay, now your site is published. Now let's go and validate how the site looking. Yeah, there is no different. There's not been a different on the store one, but yeah, if you see the store.albins.com, albinsblog.com, it's like it's showing the e-commerce product, but store.one.store.albinsblog.com is still the old content. Yeah, now let's see like how to configure the store one. So for that, I'm going to log in through the store admin. So store one, let me generate the password for now. So if you have the password already, you can use it, because I missed that. That's what I'm regenerating. Otherwise, you can use the same password. You need to update it once you generate the password. Okay, then enter that password. Fine. Now follow the same thing here. Here also WooCommerce is enabled. Then run that setup wizard. Same thing, like now you are doing for the another site. The same process you need for how many sites you want to set up. Enter some sample address. Fashion, this time I change the category. Now again, I'm going with the physical products. Continue. Same thing. Continue. Yeah, now I am again free themes. I am going to select a different theme this time. Yeah. Yeah, this says sorry, you cannot manage themes. It means like I logged in through the site admin, not via the super admin. So the site admins can't manage the themes. So what I'm going to do is I'm now going to log in through the super admin. Click on WooCommerce. This will show you the steps. Whatever left out, so yeah, you can take it from there. Continue. Okay, it's all selected already. Continue. Okay, continue. And now you can select the theme. Choose. Yeah. Yeah. Now the theme is applied. So yeah, now click on yes, please. Continue. Same thing again, add your first product. So manually, then come down little bit. You can see this design your store. Yep, let's go. Okay, now the configuration is completed. You can publish it. Now if you see here, the theme is different. Maybe we can verify the site, but the products are same. So let me go back to the sites. store.adminsblog.com. It's a e-commerce now. Theme is different. Now let me log into store1.store.adminsblog.com. Oh, sorry, store1.store. Yeah, this is again a e-commerce site, but the theme is different. So you can manage the theme, whatever the theme you want, you can apply, you can change it later. But the products are same, because it's all same sample product, same product. You can remove this product, and I will show you how you can add the new product also. Okay, now the basic e-commerce functionality is enabled. Let us now configure the store, means like shipping and the payment detail, so that we can do a checkout. For that, log into WP admin. I am doing it this for the base store, so you need to do that separately for the subdomain store. Click on the WooCommerce. Now you can see here I already completed the adding the first product. Now we can personalize our store, set up shipping, we can set up tags, then even we can set up payments also. There is a lot of other options also. I'm going to set up shipping. Same address, this is the store address. Now click on continue. Yeah, I'm saying shipping is free, so yeah, that is fine. Now set up the payment. So there is a lot of option. You can go with the PayPal, then the direct payment of card. I am going with the cash on delivery for now. So select that and click on done. Yeah, both options are now completed. Now the setup is completed. Remaining setups, whenever required, based on your requirement, you can do. Now you will be able to check out the product. Let's see, like in store.albinsblog.com. Add to cart. Yeah, go and review cart. Yeah, it's successfully added to the cart. Now you can apply the coupon or update the cart. Now I am proceeding to check out. Yeah, enter your address. Now you can see all the required details are in this page. So you can see here the shipping is pre-shipping and the cash on delivery is the billing option. So after entering all the details, you can place the order. Okay, the order is getting placed now. So order is placed. Now all the details you can see it here with the order number also. Now go to orders here, WooCommerce orders. You can see one new order got created with all the detail. You can open that order detail and you can find out. So its status is processing. So the status can be changed based on the order processing. See, there is a different. Yeah, there is different order status: processing, on hold, completed, cancelled. So you can change it based on that. Let me now add a sample product into this store one dot store. I'm not going to add it for store, so only to store one. This is a local product to this store. For that, you should be logging to WP admin. Also, I want to do that. I want to add the product through the store admin, not through the super user. So let me log in. I will log in with store one. Even you can do that, you can add the product through super admin, but I want to specifically do through the store admin. Okay, that's fine. Let me come to the products. You can add new product here. I'm going to name it same sample. Now, if you want, you can add a media. I'm ignoring that. So then, keep a price, maybe 12, then 11. So sales price should be less than regular price. If you want, you select different product type. I'm going with a simple product type. Then product description, I'm going to say sample store one product. So any other detail you want, you can add link to product, shipping, inventory, attributes, all those details you can add it. Now if you come here, like you can see the, you can even change the status to product review. But anyway, I'm not going to do anything on that. Visibility is public, then publish immediately. You can change it to on that particular day you can release it. Now I am going and doing a publish. Yeah, it's published. Now now let me go and refresh my store one. Let me search for this product, sample store one. Yeah, I am able to see. So actual price is 12 and it became $11. Now sample store one product, I will be able to add to cart and I will be able to check out also. But if I go to this store, this is my base store, and here if I search with the same product, yeah, it will say sample store one product is not available. So the product is local, so we can manage a like a individual or the local catalog, and you can have a local product. Okay, this concludes the store setup through subdomain. We configured two stores. One is the base domain store.albinsblog.com. Another one is a subdomain store one dot store dot albinsblog.com. So like this, you will be able to configure as much subdomains required. So then you need to follow those configuration. You need to enable the domain. Then you need to configure the store in WordPress. Then like if you want, you add the local products. Now let's see how to configure the sites through subfolder, because already we have seen through subdomain. Now let's see through subfolder. Yeah, for that log into the server SSH. Yeah, now go to htdocs folder, then view the wp-engine.php file. Yeah, go to that multi-site configuration section. So here you can see your site subdomain install, make it false. Yeah, right now it's true, make it false. Yep. Okay, save the changes and restart the server. Okay, the server is restarted now. Let us now access the WP admin page. We should be accessing through the super user. The username is user and the corresponding password. Okay, now go to my sites, network admin sites. You can add new. Yeah, you can see now the site address changed. Earlier it used to ask the subdomain, now it is asking the subfolder, like store.1.albans.com, then site 1, site 2, site 3. So how many sites you want, you can create it. Now you need to do some configuration changes. Go for network setup. Yeah, now this rewrites rules are getting changed. So earlier it was different for subdomain, now for subfolder the rules are same. Different. Copy that and modify the httpd-app.config folder under the apps WordPress config conf. Okay, just to comment out the existing rules. Okay, again restart it. Okay, the server restarted. Now you go and check that. Yeah, my sites. Create a new site. Site 2, I'm going to create store 2. Okay, click on add site. Okay, now the new site is added. Now let me access the site, the new site, store2.store.albansblog.com. Yeah, sorry, it's a subfolder /store2. Okay, I'm seeing the default theme. So because the e-commerce is not enabled, you can follow the same steps to enable the e-commerce functionality for this store. Okay, this concludes the setup. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.